and Darcy fell under his spell at the weekend. Well, I've fallen in love with him too. Dave and Karen are here. In your face, yes. And to talk and sift through the weekend's delights and disasters, Craig Revel Horwood is back. You love it. This is Strictly It Takes Two. Boom, you darling. So what happens when you add a TV number cruncher to a Russian pro and factor in as many hours of dance training as you can? Well, according to Darcy, the answer is a very beautiful first dance. Please welcome Rachel Riley and Pasha Kovalev. Yay!
Did you incorporate
that into your next dance? That would be great. Oh, I know Dave and his little finger ding.
It's taking already.
Oh, we're all doing it. How did the nurse hold out on Saturday for you, Rachel?
Well, that is the question. I was fine. I was singing along all day, having a laugh with everybody. Calm.
Yeah.
And then the music came on and I checked out. I wasn't there. I just went. And then it was over. And
anybody
I was looking
here?
At Pasha. What just happened?
But you
really
did
weird.
The steps, it all seemed to come together. I wouldn't have noticed. Could you tell Pash that she'd gone?
She was gone, yeah. For a second there, she was gone. But we practiced so hard. She worked so hard. So even with her being somewhere else, her body danced actually exactly what we needed to do.
It's all in there, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's the training. Len called it a tad on the careful side. Did you think that was fair? What did you make of that, Pash?
I think because we were a little bit too nervous,
yeah.
I guess, and
yeah.
somebody went to Florida yeah. while I was dancing.
Nice little break.
Lovely trip. Yeah.
Maybe we didn't put enough energy into it, and that's what they meant by careful.
Okay.
So
right.
we just need to be there, present, and
push
harder.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
That would be nice. Can I say, my little girls thought you looked like Belle from Sleeping Beauty. She was like, it's Belle. You looked absolutely stunning. Now, you are quite elegant, obviously, there on the floor, but you said, Pash, that she's a bit like a giraffe stomping around.
Yeah.
Are you enjoying in the training room? Are you enjoying
stomping
his training?
And there's been a few animals I've been compared to.
Yeah.
Is that... Everyone
loves a little bouncy little rabbit. Is he a good teacher? Do you like his methods? Okay, not in a waltz. Yeah, fair enough.
Well, he loves an analogy. That's why I've had all these animals out there. But he's a brilliant teacher. He'll say 17,000 different ways to explain it to me.
Okay.
And one of them will kind of stick. And then we have to stick with that.
Yeah, that does but, help. It does help.
And the brain doesn't connect with the body, and then the other way...
And the other way around. That
yeah.
will all come. The thing is, in the training room, it is quite funny, because we've noticed that some of Pasha's training room lingo is a little bit confusing. Have a look at this.
As you're running around, you see how I'm adjusting it.
Okay.
Around. What comes around, goes around. Or what goes around, actually gets around. Yeah, I like that version better. If you go around, then you will get around.
Good.
Yeah, go for it.
Cool.
It's true.
What is he talking about? How have you got on with the ballroom shoes? They're quite strange, aren't they? You found them quite painful.
Yeah,
here.
I got blister after blister after blister with the ballroom shoes. Yeah, it got to the point in one training where I put them on and kind of went, I'm fine. And I just couldn't really walk because one of them's really, really in there. I love the Latin shoes.
I know.
The Latin shoes—they're
a bit more sort of forgiving, aren't
they're
they?
Fine, but I was in the socks and the blister plasters, and it was all very sexy.
It's got it pain. It's like you said in Fame, isn't
plasters.
It? Okay. Also, how are you getting on? Does the maths, you know, brilliant mathematical brain, does that help with the maths of dance and the floor and counting the steps?
It doesn't help in the slightest. Everyone can count to eight, and I think that's
most
pretty
of
much.
Us.
Is that all we have to do? Eight? We haven't got to go higher than that, do we?
Two, three in walls. But,
yeah.
You know.
Yeah. So up to eight is sorted.
Okay.
So I think that's all of us.
But not much handling.
Well,
you know.
I found, especially learning the waltz to start with, my brain was the problem. It wasn't computing.
Your brain is never normally the problem. You of all people.
I was worried about my feet, but it was the brain.
This weekend, it's the salsa. How's it going so far?
I'll let you
take
that one.
Getting there.
I'll take it.
That's encouraging.
Yeah. Well, salsa is totally different from waltz, obviously.
Yeah,
we need to bring a little bit more fire into it.
Yes,
yeah.
Len said he wants some welly. Is he going to get some welly this weekend?
Well, I've just listened to the 50% acting, so I'm going to have to up my acting game. But it's so quick. If you miss one step on that, then no one's going to happen.
I think you
keep
will
smiling.
Be brilliant. Good
keep
luck
wiggling.
This weekend. Rachel and Pasha, everybody.
Thank you.
Oh, how do we get it all in? That is it for today, sadly. Thanks to all my guests. I'm back tomorrow at 6:30 when I'll be joined by Deborah and Robin, Tony and Aliona, and Natalie and Artem. Plus, Karen's back. We'll see you tomorrow. Good night.